I've definitely gotten some people who've said that they find the animations disturbing. These are very abstract and foreign landscapes, and how do we get people to not be intimidated by them?
Add a guitar solo.
Yeah, maybe it's just, you know, a Jimi Hendrix background or something.
This is my secret life.
This is my secret life.
This is my secret life.
I'm a big fan of trying to think about tools that are made in Hollywood for the entertainment industry and sort of reusing them for biology. I went to Hollywood and I took a class teaching animation software that was a little bit more advanced than the software that I had learned up to that point. And I would go to a meeting called SIGGRAPH that focuses on computer graphics. People present things like how to make King Kong's fur clump together in a realistic and sort of dirty way. And I would watch this and I'd be like, you know, this is really interesting. I was thinking about how I could take the same tools and use them in sort of a molecular type way. Maya, the software that I use, has a system for animating hair. And so I've used hair quite a bit to animate molecules moving. I've used hair to make the backbone of RNA, for example. I'm really excited about software that are used to animate crowds. So in Lord of the Rings, there's these like armies of elves and armies of orcs that are kind of making independent decisions based on their surroundings. The way we think about proteins is not that different. Proteins are making decisions based on what's around them. And so it would be really awesome to use some of these tools from Hollywood to do bigger and better biology visualizations. When I first entered sort of the graphics world, it was really exciting for me. So around this time, my husband and I went to see Ratatouille, and I'd be jabbing him, and I'd say, oh my gosh, look at that cheese! It's so real looking! Look at how the light goes through it! And my husband would be like, shh, you know, I'm trying to enjoy the movie. But I felt a little better when, at one of these meetings, one of the people from Pixar talked about the cheese, how they had worked so hard to get the light going through it just right so it looked delicious as well as realistic. So I felt a little gratified because I knew it looked like a hard thing to be able to render, and I think it was a challenge for them.
So you were vindicated.
Yes, I felt better. I was like, I was totally worth a jab.